Yeah. Yeah.
Pick up a book, everybody. It's the Cali Kickback.
Oh, I didn't know we were starting.
Man.
What's happening? It's your boy Lewis Belt.
Pick up a book or put it down. I don't know. It's your boy Theo Brown.
Oh.
Hey, but no, I'm Teddy Ray.
I was going to say, people don't really be calling you that shit, bro.
Theo Brown?
Hell yeah.
I mean, I used to go by Theo in high school. Niggas that really know me, they'll still be like, hey, what up, Theo?
For like, sure, but it's going to be fans that's going to be walking up on the street talking, what's up, my nigga Theo? You're like, well, I know you from,
man. Man, I'm about to square up with a nigga like, we ain't go to school, bro. I knew you, man, back used to have such and such class. Nah, nigga. Do niggas do you like that? Like, you remember me?
Yeah, I hate when people, I got to learn, like, what do you do? Like, you be fake or you be like, oh, I remember
nah,
you?
Nah, I mean, I just bumped into a nigga, he came to my show. We went to high school together.
Uh-huh.
So I remember him.
Uh-huh.
But it was like, wow, they get like,
I'm at that age now where I'm forgetting about who, like, I'm forgetting
who you went to school with.
For sure. Cause I'm 28, so my 10-year reunion shit, I guess, I don't know who did the fucking reunion. Let me know if you went to Deer Valley. Did y'all niggas have a reunion for 2012? Cause I ain't hear nobody. I don't know nobody even mentioned this shit. My mama told me our shit was 10 years.
Oh, she had to tell you like, you know your 10-year coming up, baby.
Nah, she was just like, you been out of high school for 10 years. She ain't never said about no reunion, none of that shit. So I'm like, I don't even know my class had that shit. Did you?
I think a lot of these newer, we ain't. Them niggas might have did one post on Facebook, nigga. Like, ooh. Class 08, say something great, nigga. Nigga, two niggas left a message.
Yeah, I don't be remembering certain motherfuckers from high school. I just be like, I always be like, damn, you look familiar, though. That's my shit. I be like, you for sure look familiar.
I hate when niggas be like, you remember Brianna cousin? Such and such and stuff. Like, no. Just some random bitch named Ruby. It was 3,000 kids at that school.
Yeah, and I only went to my high school for 1 year, so I really don't remember nobody. I'm like, if I ain't put my dick in you, I kind of don't remember your ass. I love everybody. Thank you so much.
Hello.
What about you? Who you remember from high school?
I remember my whole clique. I still be having, I be, nigga, I laughed all of high school. I laughed and slept.
that sound like your life right now. Like, nigga, you saying nothing new.
I laugh and slept all of high school. Anybody that know me knows I'll fall asleep with the quickness of class.
Damn.
And I'll get kicked out. Just
what you used to get kicked out of school for?
Talking, bro.
For real?
My mouth.
For real?
I was not a bad kid, bro. Yeah. And I be getting kicked out like, these niggas really is bad. Like, this nigga just stole a car. Like, I know this nigga. Like,
yeah.
Niggas is bad kids. Like,
yeah.
I'm in here for talking.
Yeah. On my mama.
This shit crazy.
Y'all had OCS in LA?
What's that?
On campus suspension.
Hell no.
They called that shit OCS.
Nigga, you
just, where you used to go, like, when y'all get in trouble in school, like in class, they ain't send y'all off to another class?
I got sent to the hallway.
What?
Yeah. Go stand in that hallway till you learn your lesson.
Niggas used to do that elementary. What about like middle school,
nigga,
high school?
High school, nigga. We in the high school. I'm in the hallway, nigga, just walking around the school, nigga. Just
what?
And then I'll try to stay close to the door and shit, you know.
Wow. Yeah, they used to do the hallway in elementary type shit. Am I tripping? Put a comment right now if y'all school had OCS. You had OCS? That okay. That's
on
the Sacramento.
Suspension?
Yeah, on-campus suspension, nigga. That's where you go. So after you get kicked out of class and they send you to OCS, and then you be in there with all the motherfuckers that got kicked out of their class. So it usually be like 12 motherfuckers in there, like 4 to 12 people in there, and they just tell you to be the fuck quiet. But niggas in there fighting, you know, bitches in there, you know.
Doing hair and shit.
All type of shit. Motherfuckers sucking titties, everybody. It's just a bunch of bad motherfuckers. Just
why do niggas always find time to suck a titty on school campus?
On my mama. Roast each other. On my mama. OCS niggas, you get roasted. Niggas start fighting. Now you getting kicked out the school. Because now you done fought in OCS because niggas was roasting.
You supposed to be in there chilling.
You supposed to be quiet. If you couldn't be quiet, that's set up for failure. Because if you couldn't be quiet in a real class with good people, what the fuck you think you gonna be quiet in there with a bunch of bad niggas? That's dumb.
And everybody gotta prove themselves.
Yeah, not everybody hard. Everybody hard and all the bitches is ready.
Man.
You know, and then you ain't gonna last in that motherfucker. That's crazy. I ain't had OCS. That's crazy.
Yeah, detention though, like that ain't, but that's after school. They wanted your time after school, I feel like.
Oh, so detention. Yeah, detention was, yeah, that's like OCS.
But that's
after school.
Yeah.
Oh, that's weak.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So, nigga, you...
Now you missing out on all the shit that's going on.
All the activities, whatever, lol. Such and such fighting over at Taco Bell.
Ooh.
It was a good fight, too. I seen that shit on a pixelated-ass sidekick,
sick.
Nigga.
Sick, that's weak. Damn. We were supposed to be talking about something outside of school.
Why
we
go always, to school, man.
Why we always be talking about school?
Get
on
your
this
education,
podcast?
Man.
We traumatized. I hope the kids don't watch this show because they going to be like, shit, look at Lou and Teddy. Them niggas always talk bad about school. They all right?
They all right. You got to do they that, right. though. Look around and see who fucked up in life, who succeeded. A lot of times, niggas that fucked up in life did everything right. They listened to all their teachers, everything, mm-hmm. and followed every law. And, nigga, because they believed that being right made you better than people, nigga, they had an entitled downward spiral fallout with life.
Mm-hmm. Nah, for real. Because adult life is about, like, not following the rules damn near. Like, it ain't no rules to be an adult. You got the law.
You
can't break
the
law, but... Nigga, there ain't no rules to how to be an adult. It's just, nigga, get your shit together. Step it up.
Another try. Another swing.
Oh, mama.
This shit.
That's why all the hood niggas be getting money. Because it's like, now they can do whatever the fuck they want to do. And all these kids that was hella good don't know how to get no money because they too know
I
how to...
I need a boss. I need a this. I need a that. Yeah. Lil Ray Ray and Lil Pookie, them niggas been
them
making
niggas
their own
got
breakfast
rollies
since 4 years
and hella
old, nigga. They been self-sufficient.
Oh, mamas, that's what it's about.
Man.
Oh, mamas. Holding yourself accountable, nigga. Shit.
Walk your little brother to school. They both 6. Talking about walk your little brother to school, nigga.
Oh, mamas.
Through the trenches. All kind of shit.
All type of shit. You got to learn how to cook, clean, walk home, fight for yourself.
Outrun crackheads.
All type of shit. Catch the bus.
Oh, public transportation was the worst. You got dropped off at school or you got a ride?
I done went to so many schools. I went to school always.
I got dropped off.
Now I done got dropped off, walked certain schools. I could walk certain schools. I had to get dropped off because of the distance. Feel me? And then it got to the point where my mom like, nigga, this school shit just over with. Stay your ass at home, nigga. You independent study.
And wow.
And then shit. It was over after that.
I had to deal with that that LA transit system.
That's bunk. That's not bunk, though. That's probably fun.
Fun?
Yeah.
What? Niggas is getting banged on? Like, this is... LA buses was not the business back in the day, nigga. Depending on what bus you was riding. And
damn.
What stops you got off at.
Niggas getting banged on the bus?
Yes, bro. And I've seen niggas call niggas out like, nah, nigga, get off at the next stop, nigga, so we can catch the fade.
Wow.
Like, what? Little terrorist, nigga. Don't catch the Western bus late at night, nigga. 210 or something, nigga. Like, what?
I just think that's how y'all get down when y'all frustrated. Because shit in the Bay is just shit. Niggas on that same shit, niggas just ain't banging. You just, nigga, just sock you in your jaw for no motherfucking reason.
Just on the bus.
Yeah, like in the Bay, it was a big thing about, nah, these little niggas ain't still on that. They just really just stripping niggas now. But niggas used to go on knockout missions. That was a big thing in the Bay. Niggas just go random places, just sock niggas and take niggas' iPods. And it was basically stripping niggas, but it wasn't like...
It came with a knockout.
It was more about the knockout than versus taking something from somebody. It's just walking up, dropping niggas. So it's like, knockout missions.
It's LA niggas out here that forgot the stripping part.
What?
They forgot the stripper part.
Yeah, yeah.
They just want to knock you out.
Yeah, they just want to. We was on that on some early base shit for sure. And you can get knockout missions, that shit, getting on Bart, getting on bus, all that shit. Nigga, jaw your ass coming off Bart. Nigga, just pop. Nigga, give me your iPod, nigga. iPods was the play. Nigga, get your ass socked over an iPod.
You know what's crazy? I be feeling like, damn, nigga, but I caught the bark, and it was a nice experience.
Yikes. That's what they want you to think.
Man.
It's different for, like, random-ass white people, because, you know, you don't, like, Bart ain't just no hood shit, you feel me? It's everybody in the Bay. Everybody get on Bart. But you know what I'm saying? It's, like, two different worlds.
You got them stops.
You got them stops for sure.
Like, when you left me at that one stop.
Yeah, you remember I came and got you real fast. I said, yeah, this,
I
that.
I had street security with me, nigga. Hood nigga was like, you know where you at? I know, I fucks with you, so I ain't just gonna let you stand here by yourself. I was like,
that was a real Oakland nigga, too. He was solid, for
man,
sure.
I was like, appreciate you, bro.
I appreciate that nigga, too, because I'm like, nigga, I was on my way, good looking. Oh, mama's, yeah, you was for sure in the, you feel me?
It's 20-something, nigga, 20 niggas is on a Razor scooter, nigga. Like, it's 2003. Like, oh, yeah, you know you would have fucked
public transportation is now, dangerous.
Nigga, if you pumping your shit, nigga, you in the Jets.
Yeah, you in the Jets. You ain't on the one that's you got to pay for.
You in the Jets, nigga.
That's hella funny, bruh. What the fuck we was supposed to be talking about?
I don't know, man. Shout out to the Warriors, though.
Oh, that's what we fucking supposed to be talking about, the Warriors.
Just brought one home, another one to the West.
Another ring, you understand me? Huh? Curry, Clay, Draymond.
Fake Clay.
You understand me?
All the Clay.
Oh, that, you seen that? The fake Clay going to bruh, the arena? That was hella funny, bruh.
That's my dream, nigga. To just pull up somewhere, niggas think I'm somebody else, nigga, and I just...
He really was scoping that bitch out. Because how he know where to walk through and all the little oo-wop? They was slipping.
Yeah, I think he just knew, like, players' entrance.
Yeah.
But I think he's been there. Like, that ain't his first time at that arena.
Yeah, it has.
Yeah, so...
Bruh, they was slipping, bruh.
He paid $10,000 for the tickets, though. He had tickets.
He
didn't use them. They thought he was Clay. So wow. Now he's banned for life. Which I think is kind of...
Is he a legend?
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
Bro, legend?
He slipped through security, bro, and got off some practice shots. Yes, nigga.
He is a boy.
Like, come on now.
And he made some,
He
too.
Made a good bit, nigga.
That's
like,
probably a good-ass feeling.
They let that nigga cook for a second.
But that's bunk, though, because that's bunk because the players wasn't out there. It'd have been better if you got some shot off with Curry and Draymond, somebody passed you.
I think it was that nigga got there too early. They was like, nigga, something ain't right.
Tony Roberts did that.
Shout out Tony Roberts. Everybody was at the game, though.
That's what I'm saying. That's going harder than what Brett did, sneak in there.
Brett really snuck in and act like he was Clay, though.
He didn't even look like Clay.
Fat-ass face.
You think...
No afro.
You think that would work if he was a nigga? Because I can go past the Jordan Poole if that nigga got in. I'm telling you right now, let me get in. On my mama, nigga, I'm trying
he
to...
He was not passing
shit.
For Jordan
nigga,
Poole.
Nigga, I get off with me and Jordan Poole. Nigga, I get off, nigga. Walk right up in that bitch. I'm Jordan Poole.
I'll take this hat off and do Wiggins.
That nigga said Wiggins.
Somebody in the comments like, hell no, nigga, you is not.
Boy, they gonna tear your ass up in the comments. Bro, Wiggins, your ass can go for Looney a little bit more than Wiggins.
Hell no, I'm talking shit.
Damn, who could I go for? Yeah, I could just only go for Poole. Damn, that's weak, bro. Nigga, I go as Bradley Beal on these niggas and get in. Nigga be blow fucking with me. Nigga. You could have got in the N1. You could have been Escalade.
Fuck you, nigga.
Escalade a legend. RP Escalade.
Rest in peace.
Did you know that was Mark Jackson's brother?
Mm-mm.
Bro, that's Mark Jackson's brother.
For real?
Blood brother. I did not know that. I was watching
30 for 30?
Something he was talking about it.
They just had a 30 for 30 on N1.
Oh, okay.
Hosted by Jadakiss. That shit was hard.
Oh, yeah, I bet that was going. You said hosted by Jadakiss. I'm like, that's going. Yo, that shit was crazy.
I really feel like I'm back in the time, man. N1 changed the game now, bro. I don't think Steph Curry would shoot how he shoot if it wasn't for N1.
None of them niggas on N1 could shoot. All of them was handlers.
I'm saying the showboating.
Yeah, the showboating.
Like, shooting it from hella far, nigga, that's showboating, nigga.
These kids don't even fuck with N1. They don't know nothing about that.
But they don't know that they was raised by that shit, nigga. Hot sauce, all that dribbling between the legs and crossing niggas up and... All them niggas do that, bro.
We was inspired by... where Hot Sauce at? Anybody seen Hot Sauce?
I don't know. Shout out to Hot Sauce.
A comment. Because that nigga was the nigga, and I heard about him and shit about 10 years.
Niggas didn't make the league, bro.
He don't got no Instagram?
Skip to my Lou, where you at?
Skip to my Lou? Ain't that Ray for Austin?
Yeah, he made it to the league.
He getting money. He going crazy.
Yeah.
What's the name? The white boy. He was just in the movie. The professor? The professor. He was in the movie Hustle.
Oh, word?
Yeah, he was...
when they were doing the handles and shit.
Yep, in Philly. Yeah. Boop. He's still around.
Bro, they had everybody. You saw they had Beans in that movie?
I didn't see... You talking about this song or you seen Beans?
No, Beans.
And Hustle?
Yes.
The movie?
Yes.
I did not see Beans. You making that shit.
Hey, man,
now.
Y'all go rewatch The Hustle, bro. Beanie Siegel was in that for a split second.
And we calling it The Hustle. You know, niggas always add shit to it. The movie is called Hustle, and it's by Adam Sandler. And it's a good movie.
Y'all go watch Hustler Spirit. Hustler's Ambition.
Y'all go watch Hustler Ambition. Hey, if anybody watched the movie Hustle, put a comment.
And Flow, put a comment.
Niggas always be adding shit. Bro, Benny Siegel was not in that movie.
Benny Siegel was in The Hustle, bro. It was in Philly.
When you seen Beans, where you seen him
at? He was sitting on the couch eating beans, nigga. Pinto beans.
Hell no.
Not the couch. He was on the bench at the game.
For real?
Cheering. When they was at the park, one of the park scenes.
Hmm. What the fuck going on here?
My fucking next door, nigga. That shit thudded against the wall so crazy.
Oh, my mama.
Man.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That bitch might be concussed.
Yeah, it is Hollywood. It be all type of shit going on out here.
Man.
What I was going to say? You heard Drake album?
No, nigga.
You didn't hear Drake album?
I heard just as much as you heard walking in, nigga, when it was playing. No, nigga. This nigga Lil really pulled that question out of nowhere. You heard Drake album? We heard the same amount, nigga. No, we ain't heard Drake album.
Hey, that shit weak. I ain't gonna lie. I love Drake. I love everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you, Lil.
I heard the first song. I don't like the album cover.
I didn't even see the album cover.
It's a whole, I don't know.
For real? What
you think
look
Drake
like?
Out of here?
Nah.
No?
Nah. Drake too raw.
I think Drake is just hitting side missions right now in rap. Like, he's not focused on trying to impress niggas no more.
He know what it is. He probably ain't around niggas. He in Canada. He at that house, nigga.
He can fly some niggas out.
Wayne just got denied of going to Canada.
Damn.
Cause it's some festival or some shit. They had to replace Lil Wayne for Ludacris.
What?
Yep. Let me see.
What?
It was a festival.
I thought Drake was the nigga you call when you try to cross the border.
I know, right?
Don't rap that bar, nigga. If you're not the nigga that's gonna get me across, bro.
Facts, huh?
Cause I'll call Russell Peters. That's really the nigga in Canada. Russell Peters to get me across the border.
Shout out my nigga Russell Peters.
Shout out Russell Peters.
We gotta tell him to come on the show.
Man, Russell Peters,
pull
man.
Up on us, man.
Come to the Young OG show.
Oh, my mama. I just seen that shit on social media. Lil Wayne just got denied of going to Canada. But yeah, he probably ain't around enough niggas. He probably in that big ass house out there trying to get creative in that quiet ass city. And nigga, he come up with all this mall making music.
Mall making music, wow.
You know how the shit you hear when you go walking through the mall, you hear that shit? You be like, ooh, these jeans nice.
I ain't heard
nice.
The whole album yet, so I can't say the album is trash.
That nigga made a Zara playlist. That shit sound like all shit you hear in Amber Comrie French.
Man, you just gonna pronounce every store wrong. Abercrombie and French. And Friddle me this.
I ain't been in that motherfucker. Hell yeah. Nigga make
it. Ancient M&M's. This nigga blew a real old southern nigga at heart. Don't mispronounce every story.
You know niggas don't know how to say Abercrombie and Fitch. Niggas say, now I'm going to the Abercrombie store. That's how niggas say when they finna go get some jeans. I'm finna go to the Abercrombie store.
Abercrombie, man.
You say it.
I'm finna go to the mall.
When you at the mall, what store you going to?
I'm at the store.
You remember Hollister was the shit?
Yeah.
Niggas used to fucking with Hollister.
Niggas thought Hollister made them whiter.
Niggas thought Hollister was gonna get them white bitches.
Nah, they would have had a strap on them and all kind of shit. Uh-huh. Pills. They thought wearing a Hollister sweater or something was gonna let the police just. No, y'all keep going. I'm wearing Hollister.
Shout out my nigga Simba. He swore he was the reason why niggas in the Bay was wearing Hollister. He said it in a song. He was serious too. He was like, I'm the reason why you niggas rock Hollister. I gotta ask that nigga. Do you really think you the reason people was wearing Hollister in the Bay? Because was they wearing Hollister in L.A.?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. And
but he didn't say he was the reason for L.A. The Bay is a different market.
Yeah, but, you know, Bay niggas where they made up everything.
Y'all still was wearing kitty-ass backpacks. Grown niggas.
Oh, mama SpongeBob backpacks.
Bad
all
as
shit.
Going dumb on top of school buses. Like,
was mobbing.
Bro, you are 32, nigga. What is you doing? Ghost ride the school bus, nigga.
Yeah, and y'all was over there fucking wearing khakis and dub scene walking and whatever the fuck y'all was doing.
I wanna roll. I wanna ride. Throw my hood up high.
What's the song? What's the song? All the OGs playing L.A. on their Harley?
What did I say?
I said all the OGs in the Bay in Oakland, them niggas be my shit bang, my shit bang, my shit bang. Niggas be.
If a nigga ain't slapping old school out here, they slapping like something like Corrupt. We can freak it. We can freak it. Freak if you want to. Grind if you want to. And you know,
Oakland OGs be slapping, blaming on the alcohol, blaming on niggas be mugging, wah wah wah, trying to go sideways. That's hella funny.
I ain't gonna lie, these hood niggas, LMA hit the hood hard too.
Oh, for real?
I heard hella niggas' feelings. So deep in the feelings. Ooh. Niggas was hitting the hood. Everybody was slapping that.
Hello, mama.
Something new. Niggas was line dancing. Go to a backyard barbecue. Niggas was line dancing to LMA.
Nigga, in Oakland, nigga, you'll hear all hood niggas will start crying at that. Guapalay start playing. Closer to my dream. You just start seeing niggas with dreads. Dropping tears. Oh, mama, nigga.
I'm getting high and upward and onward. Shout out to Guapalay, bro. I told you I danced with her one New Year's.
You jawsing.
I swear to God.
Niggas always got crazy ass stories. You know I got a lap dance by Kelly.
I never said a lap dance, nigga. We was two-stepping.
Like, nigga, we need you to get a lap dance by Kelly.
I was two-stepping with Guapalay New Year's at Russell Peters' house.
Hood niggas be having hella random ass stories. You know Michael Jackson was my uncle. Like, nigga, when did... Nah, I didn't know that.
LA niggas just be having random stories, nigga.
Y'all be having hella stories with famous people. Nigga talking about Usher was across the street from my school and shit. Like,
he was. He was across the street from my middle school.
Nigga seen Usher. Nigga, the most famous nigga we seen in the Bay in middle school was fucking Mr. Fab and Keek the Sneak, nigga.
I was finna say Keek.
Nigga, Keek, it was the Nig, nigga. Old mamas, nigga. Hey, I don't even want to say this, but this shit hella funny. Keek the Sneak daughter went to my school, and she was like, she didn't like everybody like talking about like, all right, Keek the Sneak, your daddy. But every time we used to see her, we'd be like, sup, pump, sup, hey. Hey, she used to get hot.
Yeah, I would too, nigga. Let me live a regular life.
I bet that is hella annoying. Like, nigga, Keek Sneak my pop, so nigga, everywhere I go, everybody just rapping my daddy lyrics.
Like, it's so many kids of niggas out here. You just gotta act like they normal people, bro.
Oh, my mama.
That's the key to the game. You be acting juice about who they are, what they are. What do you like to do, nigga? Like, I don't know. Nigga, I know your pops, nigga. MC Hammer, nigga. What do you do?
Oh, mama. But see, the Bay ain't used to fame, nigga. Drake, nigga, Keek the Sneak was like Drake for the Bay, nigga. That was the biggest nigga out. Oh, mama's nigga didn't know how to act. So that shit crucial. But yeah, nah, Drake shit ass. I love everybody. But I think he doing it on purpose. I think not on purpose. I don't think that. I just think he out there in Canada, he fucking at peace. You understand me? And he wanted to make some
Yeah, being at peace will fuck your art up.
You see what I'm saying?
That's why niggas keep chaos in their life to keep shit balanced.
Nigga, I was hella funny, nigga, when I was traumatized. I'm still traumatized, but
oh, I know what you mean, nigga. Yeah. You start working through your shit, being a better person.
It's hard for me to be Sonic Bo, nigga. I don't feel like Sonic Bo all day. Nigga, I was coming with skids back to back, nigga, because that's how I felt every day. It's like Sonic Bo. I don't feel like Sonic Bo. So it's like, nigga, I got to come up with some shit. I got to be around some Sonic Bo niggas.
You got to be around some angry niggas.
You feel me? And then be like, ooh, that's a skit. Yeah. You know, that's some Sonic Bo shit.
Yeah, that shit. Because that's what they did to Mary J. Blige. They wrote her off as soon as she got peaceful.
Mm-hmm, yep.
As soon as she got happy.
People so fucked up,
no
too.
No more drama in my life.
Oh, my mama.
No drama. He was like, all right, bitch, you bumping Keisha Cole now.
Yeah, exactly. Where the other toxic lady at?
We on to some K. Michelle now. Who else been hurt?
Oh, mamas. The world fucked up. They'd rather have Mary J. hurt to make good slaps than her happy weak making weak music.
I like Mary J.'s happy shit. Just fine.
Ooh, that shit do black. My mama don't like Mary J. happy.
For real?
Oh, my mama. Every time Mary J. drop a happy album, my mama be like, I ain't feeling it. My mama want to hear motherfucker.
She want to lock that Zen room and get the tears going.
Oh, my mama. She trying to fight them Oakland demons. I swear Mary J. Blige my auntie.
Like, 11 years.
If I ever meet Mary J. Blige, I'm FaceTiming moms off the dribble, and I'm acting like they really supposed to be friends.
I was on a FaceTime with somebody, like, never mind.
What?
I was about to say, I was on a FaceTime when they was FaceTiming Kim. I was like, I was going to FaceTime my mama when they was on their FaceTime. So I know what you mean. Like,
yeah.
You be around somebody, you want to FaceTime them for moms?
Oh, my mama, Mary J. Blige. I can't allow to talk. I can't let me talk to Mary J. Blige without having moms there or FaceTiming. But that's mandatory. And I think for pops, it's Jordan. I can't see that nigga Jordan without calling my pops. Well, if I call my dad, that nigga Jordan, no FaceTime.
I feel like Jordan will fuck around and walk away before that nigga pick up. Hold on, he's taking. Hold on, Jordan. I'm just going to.
You know, Ted, I would call you if I bumped into Jill Scott.
For real?
I would call you. I swear. If I bumped into. When I see Jill Scott,
just
I think
send me the location. Don't call me. Send me the location, nigga. I'll be there quick.
Bro, that's hella funny. Damn.
Shout out to Jill Scott.
I'm trying to figure out. If you see Obama, nigga, you got to call me. That's the only nigga left right now on my bucket list, nigga. Don't. You can damn near call me if you bump into Denzel. Call me, nigga. That's my nigga. I fuck with Denzel.
I was about to say, every Bay nigga that's a legend, you fuck with already, so it wouldn't make sense to call you. hey, I'm with 40. He'd be like, all right. I was with that nigga last night.
Yeah, it would have to be like Obama, one of them niggas now.
I'm with Lloyd Banks. I'm going to call that nigga Lou.
Don't call me when you with Lloyd Banks. I love Lloyd Banks. I love everybody. But I'll be like, shit, what's up with it, boy? I'll be like, Ted, what you got going on?
Shit, over here at the G-Unit compound.
I'll be like, hey, where that nigga 50 at? That's fucked up, huh?
Hey, Banks, we're fifth.
But Lloyd Banks a legend, though. Is he a legend?
You trying to have a whack 100 conversation?
Nah, that's a good question. Lloyd Banks a legend, nigga.
To me, he is. I grew up in the Lloyd Banks G in the era. So.
I'm so fly. I got money. Things I buy. I'm so fly. Oh, my mama, that nigga was going. Beam a Benz Bentley. That nigga was going. Niggas got Lloyd Banks.
I stay saying because I'm cooler than the other side of the pillow, nigga. To this day, because of Lloyd Banks.
My mama,
I'm
Lloyd
cooler
Banks
than the other side of the pillow, this motherfucker.
We daring to get Lloyd Banks on this podcast. We daring to DM that nigga. Nigga, pull up. I know you ain't doing shit. Come on, man. Nah, we got Lloyd Banks fucked up.
Man.
I'm just playing.
There's some rap niggas out there that really ain't did shit this week. Ain't went to the studio, nothing. Nigga.
Oh, my mama. Chingy ain't doing shit right now. Oh, my mama. That nigga better not tell me he can't pull up. He busy. Nigga, what you
Petey
doing?
Petey Pablo.
Petey Pablo, a legend, nigga.
He better not be that busy, though.
That nigga might be busy. Freaking Leaks are black. That nigga might got a show. Freaking Leaks. Tanya. Keisha. Taronda.
Freaking Leak.
You don't think
Monique.
Petey Pablo? You don't think?
Christina. I just know he better not be that busy.
You don't think Petey Pablo busy? We got to look up that nigga on Instagram.
Look up that nigga tour schedule right now.
Let me see. Petey Pablo.
We got Petey Pablo fucked up.
We got Petey Pablo fucked up. I don't even know how to spell that nigga name. Pablo. All right, here we go.
Who better be free?
Is this nigga Instagram? Nah. I don't even think Petey Pablo got Instagram.
See, he probably only got Facebook. So that nigga's free, yes.
Damn. Oh, here, go right here. His Instagram is Big Petey Pablo. No, it's Big Papa Petey.
Wow.
And they got 70K. He said, for all Petey Pablo bookings, please call G, and it's a phone number. Let's book that nigga. Nigga, if you bring Petey Pablo to the Bay, that'd be juice. I'll bring that nigga to Antioch.
Why to Antioch?
Because, nigga, Antioch might be juice. Oakland might fuck with Petey Pablo. Bring that nigga to Rob Benz. Nigga, niggas be like, nigga, that's nigga a legend.
Yeah, we got Petey Pablo fucked up.
We got Petey Pablo fucked up. Let me know right now. Would y'all pop out if Petey Pablo came to town? I'm fucking with him.
That's unk.
That nigga probably got hella story, hella OG stories.
Nah, he for sure got some stories. Because he was at the top of the rap game, nigga.
Oh, my mom. Like,
what? Put the waves up.
Let me see. Let me see how he look.
He wearing the Pusheisty mask now, nigga. He trying to be
that nigga like
bro.
Benny Siegel. Damn, he got 300 likes.
Why you do the legend like that, dog?
Yeah, because it really don't matter. He really legend. Fuck the likes. But he OG for sure. Yeah. That'd be a good-ass guest to come on here. I'm a DM him right now. Hey, Unk, man, come fuck with us on the podcast. What's up,
we
Unk?
We got the Cali Kickback. See that nigga the Addy.
What's up, Unk? Fuck with us. Fuck with us. On our podcast.
Put in the comments who y'all think we could afford to fuck with right now. Who y'all would come pull up to see.
What's up? What's up?
Who y'all think is free?
Yeah, who got time?
Who got time?
us on our podcast.
Who ain't did shit all week, ain't made a beat.
I just DM'd him.
Nigga just made hella breakfast.
Can y'all see? I just DM'd Petey Pablo, see if he gonna respond. Now, if he don't respond...
You know what's crazy? I think this nigga's kind of busy, but I feel like he's kind of free, too.
Who?
Devin the Dude.
Who is that?
From Texas.
Uh-uh.
What? Never mind.
Y'all know who that is?
Yeah.
Oh, for real? Because I got high, that nigga?
Hell no, he wait, man.
That nigga booked.
Afro Man?
Yeah, he popping. Afro Man popping. Don't play with Afro Man.
Afro Man got the white fans. That's why.
That's what I'm saying. He lit. Don't play
he
with
stay
Afro.
Popping.
He gonna perform. I got high in me.
He did a...
Oh, my mama.
420, that nigga's calendar is lit.
I think we got Chingy fucked up.
You Chingy. Said Chingy with authority.
Yeah, Chingy probably got shit to do, huh?
Who's the other nigga in the St. Lunatics? Kiwan?
Murphy Lee, you think he booked? You think he busy?
Yeah, Murphy Lee probably.
Murphy Lee, you think so? Yeah. We sound OG.
I think Murphy, but he ain't busy rapping. That nigga make incense or soaps.
Oh, he really do?
I don't know.
Oh.
I just feel like that's his hustle right now.
I just. Nah, Murphy Lee can pull up. He gonna pull up on us for sure.
Dirty.
This nigga dry.
Dirty ENT.
Nah, this nigga drier than Petey Pablo.
Nah, man.
Nah, they the same.
Don't do dirty like that.
Nah, this nigga dry, bro.
Bruh.
This nigga dry.
Hey, bruh, get off my nigga Murphy Lee head, bruh.
I fuck with Murphy Lee. He a legend.
What the hook gonna be?
Oh, I don't hear a fucking hook on this beat. Ooh, they going. They should have, see, Jason Tatum should have had them perform at halftime. Because, you know, St. Louis. That would have been going.
But it's Boston, though. Them niggas, they racist. They don't want to see no niggas dancing at halftime.
They let Nelly perform?
When?
He performed at halftime in Boston.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
Oh, that's Nelly, though. Nelly. Hot and Hurt ain't a black song no more, nigga. That's everybody's shit.
Yeah, that's facts. Yeah. It'd be hella white bitches at the club. That's how you know a club ass when you hear that shit. It's getting hot in here. Well, you'd be like, this go. Motherfucker weak. Well, talking about $10 cover charge.
But
I'm
if
not
you hear E.I., that motherfucker going up.
Oh, mamas, huh?
Underlay, mommy. Like, what's what's popping tonight, eh?
Oh, shit, bro.
Niggas act like Nelly wasn't that nigga, bro.
Nelly you can call and Ja Rule, said even I even did it.
Nelly and Ja Rule, nigga, you niggas was not dodging them niggas in the early thousands, bro. You wanted that feature back in the day, my nigga. Yes, you did.
You seen that video where Ja Rule's performing at halftime, and he's like, "Are you ready?" And nobody said nothing. That shit was hella funny.
First off, nigga, like, why are you at a Milwaukee Bucks game? You're not from Milwaukee, nigga. Like, that's not your fan base, Ja Rule. You can't just take every bag, nigga.
I think Ja Rule can sell out a show. Not
hell
sell,
yeah.
Yeah, not sell out, but like, yeah.
Did you see his verses?
He did the verses?
Man, that nigga washed the fuck out of Fat Joe.
Oh, swear. Yeah. Oh, yeah, he a boy.
He washed the fuck out of Fat Joe.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Joe knew what he was doing.
Yeah, Joe.
Joe was just like, I just want the ratings off Ja Rule, nigga. Like, basically.
Joe got hits, though.
Joe got hella hits.
And that nigga be fresh. Joe Legend for sure.
I remember he had that whole licking your bottom of your shoes. Like if they fresh.
Oh, yeah.
I remember he had hella niggas licking their
I
shoes.
I bet his big ass did start that.
Now I look back like, you niggas is nasty.
I know, right? Because they ain't hit the ground don't mean they lickable.
Somebody might have tried them on at the factory.
I think my dumb ass did that shit when I was younger,
I for sure did that shit.
I think I did.
Shout out to Fat Joe for being influential.
Oh, my mama. I think every nigga done grabbed some forces and licked them bitches.
Awesome. Yeah, nigga, fresh. I was like,
you damn near bring that shit back.
Hell no.
Bet. These little niggas will follow anything now. I was somewhere, I don't know where the fuck I was at. I had to put a helmet on.
Special ed class?
Nah, I wasn't there. It was somewhere I was at.
Did you?
Nah, I'm saying like recently. I had to put a helmet on type shit. Niggas said special ed class. I had to put a helmet on somewhere. I don't know where the fuck. I was doing some little activity. But it made me think.
Finger painting?
Nah, where the fuck I was at? I can't remember right now.
You were ziplining?
I had to put a helmet on ziplining. And it was somewhere else. I forgot. But it just made me think, like, you could put on a helmet now and make that a trend. I think niggas will walk around with a helmet. Like, let little baby wear a helmet and be like, nigga, I'm dripping in this new helmet. You niggas can't stop me. I'm the flyest out. Woo, woo.
Yeah.
And he rock a helmet. Nigga, everybody would be really wearing helmets. You got to think about it. Kanye West got niggas wearing homeless shoes. Like, 50 Cent had niggas wearing bulletproof tank tops.
With no arm definition.
Bunk.
I'm out here like this because it's hot. Y'all kiss my ass, nigga. It was 100 degrees today.
Yeah, it's hella hot. I think niggas will wear helmets. But what I'm going to do, I think I'm going to try to start a trend. I think I could start a trend.
What kind of trend?
I don't want to do no dumb shit, but I kind of just want to test my clout. Like, nigga, if I could get, I could probably put on a helmet. Nigga, I know some of these niggas copying all this other shit I got going on. All I got to do is wear a helmet, nigga, see who copying. As soon as you wear a helmet, then you know this nigga copying Lewis.
Everything ain't, you know.
You swear niggas is wearing hats because of you. You can't prove that. Put a helmet on. Damn, that's how niggas be like, I ain't gonna lie. Niggas was not wearing helmets before Teddy Ray.
I didn't
Ray.
Say niggas was wearing hats because of me.
You said, fat niggas.
A certain demographic of fat niggas.
You know how many fat niggas wear hats?
I was outside, nigga, in 09, nigga. Niggas wasn't wearing hats like that,
bro. It's more fat niggas than skinny niggas wearing hats.
Nah.
It's more fat niggas on this earth than skinny niggas.
Hell no. Nah.
Shit. 2022? Nah.
In America, maybe, but worldwide? Niggas,
oh, yeah. In America. In shape. USA. It's big niggas.
But I still think it's most skinny niggas, because...
Y'all put a comment. What y'all think? Niggas is big. There's
look
a lot of big
look
niggas.
Around on your next flight and see how many me's you see.
Facts.
On that motherfucker.
Just go outside right now and notice how many motherfuckers is big. And I'm tired. I ain't gonna lie, it's 2022. Y'all people that's big, stop blaming the pandemic. Nigga, that was 2 years ago. I gained weight during the pandemic, especially these bitches. Mr. Ma, I ain't gonna lie, I gained weight in the pandemic.
I did, though.
Yo, ass big before the pandemic.
But I did gain weight, though, in the pandemic. At the top of the pandemic, though, I was on my shit. I was vegan. I was doing my shit, nigga. I damn near... lost weight, and then...
You blaming your pandemic for your weight gain?
I went on 2 back-to-back road trips nationwide. And, you know, it ain't shit to do in the South. It was locked down, niggas. Niggas just...
You hella funny.
We was fucking and eating, niggas. Months.
Hey, y'all people in the comments, too. Y'all keep putting comments talking about Teddy, talking about lose weight. This nigga, a grown-ass man, he doing what the fuck he want to do. Y'all stop putting them comments. That shit
it's
get
happening,
on my nerves.
Y'all. Y'all niggas act like a nigga could just blink and shed pounds, nigga. It's a process.
They talking about me. They telling, Louis, you're not being a real friend. You're not telling Teddy he's gaining weight. Fuck, I'm supposed to tell Teddy.
I can see I'm gaining weight, nigga. I'm not a blind-ass nigga. What you doing with your life? Observer. I done been this big before, so all you niggas that scared, talking about, oh, you finna die, I might be.
Don't I say might that. Be.
We all gotta die.
You right.
You too!
Yeah.
Bitch nigga in the comments, you gotta die.
It's always some nigga.
And I just hope my fat ass is at your funeral, nigga. while you were sitting up talking shit about me. Karma is a motherfucker.
Your pandemic joke was hella funny. You say, nigga, I was nervous because they talking about I'm going to be the first one to go out. That shit was funny. Yeah, I don't know. What
you looking about? You got my lighter?
But yeah, there's all type of shit going on. You seen the shit with DJ Akademics?
Him being a pedophile?
He the new R. Kelly.
He been that nigga, though.
I didn't know that.
He said Bad Bobby had mad titties for a 15-year-old years ago. What? I ain't fuck with that nigga since. What? You got mad titties for a 15-year-old nigga? I'll beat your ass, bro.
Yeah, that's crucial. Somebody need to choke that nigga. Say.
And then they were talking about NBA young. That nigga was a teenager fucking with her. Uh-huh. That's different. You can't talk about what he was doing. He was 17 his damn self, nigga.
Yeah, though. Yeah. He fucking in his age. You a
grown nigga, bro.
Yeah.
And then you also, oh, I don't care. I just need to see a college ID. I don't care if she 17 and a half. I'm fucking.
Niggas is sick, bro.
Alright.
Yeah, alright. You gotta watch these internet niggas. These niggas that be always making hella vlogs. It's probably these. That's who probably on these comments trying to talk about your ass. These fucking pedophile. Worried about niggas' weight.
It don't. You know, I appreciate those that really care, though. You know, that's real love. You feel me? I trust me. I got a girl with a nice ass right now doing my meal prep.
Oh, mama.
You feel me? Lamb chops, salmon and shit.
That ain't asparagus. Healthy, Teddy.
What?
Lamb chops?
Lamb chops is healthy.
No, it ain't.
Yes, it is.
Is lamb chops healthy?
If I'm just doing lamb and vegetables, nigga.
That's meat.
Yeah.
For real? Y'all put a comment. I don't think lamb chops healthy. I be eating lamb chops when I'm having some money and I'm feeling good and I'm doing my thing.
That don't mean it's not healthy, nigga.
Lamb chops is like...
Because you got money.
Nah, I don't think lamb chops is healthy, dude. That's like steak.
You getting it with the sides and the...
Yeah.
The buttery ass mashed potatoes. I'm not doing that, nigga.
You think lamb chops is healthy?
Hey, bro, it's in the process, nigga. I don't give a fuck. It's paid for. I'm finna meal prep some oxtails next week, nigga. The fuck?
That's hella funny. Meal prep some oxtails.
Niggas got me fucked up.
I've been trying to get on my healthier shit, too. I've been eating a lot of granola.
What that got to do with anything healthy, nigga?
Granola is good for you, right?
This nigga eat like a rabbit.
You know what I'm saying?
Granola. I've been fucking up granola.
What else is good? I've been working on my sit-ups. Sit-ups hard as a motherfucker. I be doing like 40 and bitches be like, oh, I'm done. Sit up 40. Hard. 40.
Ooh.
I got to start really doing about 100 of them bitches.
I hit 9 sit-ups, nigga, and be through.
When the last time you did a sit-up?
I'm not going to lie, this week.
For real? Was it hard? You did 9?
Nigga, them nigga that's hurt. Good.
Nigga, if I did 40, you did 9, nigga, we doing good.
I do more push-ups than anything now.
Yeah, I be on my push-up shit. Yeah. I can fuck with push-ups.
Cause I got the socking nigga mentality.
Yeah, exactly. Niggas do.
I do enough push-ups to feel like, all right, I can sock a nigga with this.
I do enough push-ups so I can just move a nigga when I need to move. Hey, bro, I'm right here, bro. Watch out. This got to be strong. All right here, nigga. You at the club, nigga. You in crowded areas, nigga. Raider games, all that. Hey, my nigga, let me get through right here.
I lifted a nigga at the basketball court the other day. I felt good about it. Nigga. Playing hella defense and shit. I just lifted that nigga. Get the fuck on, nigga. Big niggas always playing.
That's hella funny. Oh, shit.
I be telling niggas, big niggas ain't like all the way just out of shape, nigga. Niggas is professional bodybuilders, nigga. Like, we walk around with weights on daily, nigga, and get up. Like, me doing this, nigga, that's like bench pressing 100, nigga.
You should make that a joke on your stand up. That's funny. You is walking around with hella weight on you.
Man.
Nigga, you lifting weights all day. Nigga talking about you working out? Yeah, nigga, I'm walking around my body. I'm working out.
Doing this, nigga. I sat up, nigga. That's I'm working out.
No, your you little ass need to work out. Yeah, that nigga look crazy. That nigga finna break his fucking rib.
Nigga finna all break for his shoulder. I seen the chick in the background filming, nigga. I was like, this nigga finna bust his whole rib cage for a bitch.
Oh, hey, we need to start editing. We need to start putting little videos on our episodes because I want the people to see that clip right now of Meek Mill.
Struggling.
This nigga lit the whole bar from the bench press. You know, you get a bench press in the bar, he grabbed
one
of them.
He's supposed to get a dumbbell and do the workout that he did. He grabbed the whole bench press
this
bar.
This nigga grabbed the whole bar. And he not even doing, you know you doing the way you could. This nigga.
It's off balance like a motherfucker.
I'm like, boy.
With the men in black worm body. That's that pick the pistol up body.
Oh, my mama.
Nah, I'ma just pick this pistol up.
Niggas be trying to, see, that's what niggas be trying to do when they ain't been working out consistently in summer coming up. Or summer here. Niggas try to work out hella hard, nigga. Like, you can't, it don't mean you working out hella hard, lifting hella heavy shit that you can't
really
lift.
All you need is calisthenics, bro. Mm-hmm. God gave you everything you need, nigga, to be the best that you can be. That's what I believe. You know, I keep trying to, regurgitate that in my brain as I'm going through my shit. But, you know.
We need a personal trainer to come on this show.
I know one.
You know one?
Well, I don't know if she a personal trainer. She just fine as fuck and be working out.
That's cool. That's good enough.
Yeah.
Oh, mama.
And I'll ask her to train me. I'm pretty sure she won't say no.
She'll train you.
Yeah.
You think it's easier to train if you had a bad bitch training you?
No.
You really be catting. I'd be catting. Now you in there flirting and shit.
Yeah.
Eating hella, drinking hella smoothies and shit. You ain't working out. You need an OG nigga to work you up. Best workout I got when I was working out with my pops, nigga, for like 2 years straight. I got buff as a motherfucker.
Hey, yo. Your pops got that early 90s Suge Knight body when he was on his bullshit.
That's what people used to thought my pops was.
Suge.
On my mama. Like, we used to go places sometimes. People used to be like, looking at shit. Like, oh, my God, I thought you was Suge Knight.
He got that Suge Knight presence.
I think that nigga more dangerous than Suge. No, I'm just playing.
Hey.
That nigga Suge. Speaking of Suge, you see they tried to do a lawsuit on Suge Knight?
For $81 million.
$81 million?
About, nigga, Suge ain't got no $81 million, bro.
You don't think Suge got 81 M's? That nigga got Snoop money. He got Dr. Dre money.
Man, the courts keep taking it. The courts keep robbing that man.
The court, but he made a lot of money,
he
bro.
He made a lot of money, but the courts took all of that shit.
How they gonna ask for 81 M's if you don't got it?
Because they could just... They just want to fuck you over indefinitely. That's it.
You can sue somebody for something they don't got?
Amber Heard ain't got 15 million, nigga. Johnny Depp just got awarded 15 M's. She got to find a way to...
What?
Pay that shit. That bitch worth like $3 million.
So you can sue a homeless person for $100,000.
It's California. You can sue a nigga for whatever.
Black people always talking about they gonna sue somebody, but niggas don't know how to sue nobody.
I know a bitch that know how to sue.
I know a bitch that know how to sue.
Her whole family. Man. Her family done hit licks, niggas, in the 90s, nigga.
I said, niggas don't know how to sue. This nigga said, I know a bitch that know how to sue.
No lie, I had to keep my eye on her. I'm like, you know.
Because she'll sue your ass. Yeah.
Niggas fuck around and fall at your house in California and be like, oh, it's your fault.
Yeah.
Rough ass floors, nigga. What?
Yeah, it was a...
What?
It was a nigga I seen. You know him too. A nigga try to sue somebody. Like, really try to sue. I'm lying. That's why I knew I'd stop fucking with that nigga. Some Hollywood nigga we know. I had this nigga around me. I'm like, oh, hell no. This nigga be trying to sue niggas. That's like a... You trying to shoot a nigga at some point. This nigga dangerous. He trying to hit a lick.
I mean, sometimes you gotta sue. Sometimes it's just...
No, it's cool to sue somebody on something if they really did something wrong, but yeah. I'm talking about, nigga, motherfuckers be suing because they broke. and you just trying to hit a lick. I don't fuck with that.
That's like shit. Soul Plane, nigga.
Yeah.
You don't take that lick.
I take that.
Even if you was broke, nigga, you'll sue the shit out them niggas. They kill your dog, suck you through a toilet while you was taking the shit.
I think I could have sued some. I think I already could have sued a few motherfuckers, I think,
you
already.
You could have, Lou. You just a nigga. You get up and keep pushing with your day. I done did the same. I done been hit by cars. All kind of shit, nigga. I get up and be like, my fault.
Oh, mama's up. Oh, my mama.
I gotta keep pressing.
Facts. Niggas have been through hella shit. I could have sued about 10 niggas by now.
Man. We could have sued them niggas a couple Sundays ago for having us outside.
I was just thinking about that. We can't tell our Cali Kickbackers.
Huh?
Is it too soon?
I don't know. You already made it obvious, nigga. What you mean?
No, we don't gotta tell them shit. I don't know. That is hot. Yeah, we'll tell y'all about 10 years from now. But yeah, we'd have been through it all, man. Just got to be your P's and Q's through these hoods, man.
Man.
But yeah, that's hella funny, bruh. Y'all go G Show coming up?
June 23rd.
June 23rd.
Fuck what you heard, all you birds and you nerds. You better observe.
You understand me?
What's the word?
A lot of special guests coming through. You understand me?
Yeah.
Get your tickets right now. The link is in the description. You understand me, all the shit.
What you got popping for Juneteenth?
Celebrate.
I don't like how corporate this Juneteenth is getting.
Yeah, I think every day Juneteenth for me. I'm a nigga that fuck with nigga shit every day.
Every day.
This is for niggas that ain't niggas that's trying to celebrate and try to blend in with the niggas.
It's crazy. It's some black people. I was out there last year. And they was like, yeah, where I live, I don't see a lot of black people like this. So I like to come out and be with my people. And I was like, yeah, come out, be with your people. But you made it seem like you was investigating us still. Like,
yeah.
Oh, what you niggas on Crenshaw doing?
Niggas be tripping on Juneteenth. Nigga, at the lake, niggas start, it was hella people that got shot at the lake in Oakland. And a nigga had switch on his Glock and hella shit. I'm like, nigga, that's Juneteenth, nigga shooting. So I'm damn near cool off niggas. Niggas, there's too many niggas now on this day. I fuck with Juneteenth for the, you know, because we got a holiday, but I don't know. I love everybody. What you gonna do?
I'm gonna be in the hood, nigga. I'm gonna be outside.
Niggas got switches on their straps, nigga.
I don't give a fuck, nigga. We praying for the hood. That's all we doing. We outside. We in Lamar Park this Juneteenth. Yeah, man.
All right, till them niggas get the bussing at y'all ass.
Hey.
This be the last Lamar Park Juneteenth you have to be at.
My ass see how long in you that fountain, nigga. The one that was behind Moesha in the beginning of that intro, nigga. Avoid them bullets.
Let me not try to be so traumatized.
Yeah, you fucking the day up already. It ain't even came.
It all might right. be a good day. It might be a good day.
It go will to the be lake. A good day. We got to get our minds right and get our don't vocabulary.
Don't act like what just happened a few weeks ago just is over.
Okay, you might as well tell them now. We got shot at, y'all. We got shot at. I don't know what to talk about. I don't know. It's a case.
And Teddy jumped on and hurt. My girl, he didn't fell on her and all type of shit, hurt her knee.
I was trying to rescue niggas.
You wasn't trying to rescue nobody. They start shooting and Teddy jumped on everybody. I ran the other direction. I dipped up out of there. So that just happened. That was damn near the first day of the summer, right?
I don't know what day it was, nigga.
I don't know what day it was, but I'm saying it was earlier in the summer, I don't right? know. That was like 2 years ago.
It was a beautiful day. That's all I remember. And out of nowhere, kah, kah, kah. I'm just happy my fat ass that they good didn't have a switch on it. I appreciate you niggas for giving me opportunity.
Nigga, if they had a switch on it, you'd have got hit 100 times.
I heard the space between the shots. Fuck, 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 fuck. I'm like, oh, this nigga ain't got no switch. Okay, praise
my God. My instinct, so A1 when it comes to gunshots, man, I got up out of there hella fast. And sometimes growing up in a bad environment is a good thing. Because that would have fucked up our comedy career. Imagine we just never was niggas that was around gunshots. And then, for the people that's at home too, this shit didn't happen at no comedy show, no shit like that. We was outside kicking.
I ain't going to let y'all know where it happened at.
I'm not telling y'all shit. I love everybody. Yeah, I'm just saying.
I ain't even want to say that. But this
you
nigga,
already told him. I didn't tell him shit.
Because you brought it up twice.
That nigga
also
said, we got shot at. Niggas get shot at
every day, you know. I pray, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, we still here.
But we gotta tell the people at home, it wasn't like we got shot at on purpose or something. This somebody was on us. We was just in an environment, Ian, Sten, me, and they start shooting. And me and Teddy was together. And I seen this nigga
we
jump
got shot
over
at, nigga. I don't give, they didn't care who they hit that day, Lou. All this, we was in an environment, nigga. Environment my ass.
Bro, anytime niggas gunfire go around niggas area, they was shooting at us. They was not shooting at us.
Bullshit. Lou. You laughing, nigga. The car next to yours was riddled.
That was crucial, for sure.
And but you acting like they wasn't shooting at us. Nigga, I thought your car was hit up, too.
Nigga, I love everybody.
What's next topic? Next topic, nigga.
They was not shooting at us. I love everybody. Yeah, that was a bad way to mention the Young OG show.
Man,
they gonna think motherfuckers shooting at us now.
There have never been gunshots at the Young OG show. I promise you, nothing but laughter and good times.
We're in North Hollywood,
man.
Good area. It's a good area, Teddy. In North Hollywood, this nigga's traumatized. You talking about me with Juneteenth and shit? You fucking up the whole LA County. That don't mean shit.
Nigga just got shot on Sherman Way.
Hell no. We was on the other side where all that ghetto shit was happening. Shout out everybody. I love the whole LA County, but that other side different from the Valley side. And I know that. And Teddy know that. But Teddy traumatized by the whole LA County. This nigga, we can be in Orange County. It's LA niggas out here. It's like, I know, Teddy, but we
cool.
It's worse than
Orange County, nigga. The Klan is out there, boy. It ain't this. You got the Ku Klux Klan mixed with all the shit.
All the niggas that's from L.A., they in the I.E. turning that motherfucker out.
Man.
Shout out all the... No, it's niggas that's really, really from Pomona and all the shit, too. But it's niggas everywhere. I love everybody. We got to do a show in the I.E., bro. The I.E. show a lot of love. I think we should do it in Ontario.
Let's do it.
Y'all put a comment. Should we do a show in the IE? Would y'all pop out to the Young OG show in the IE?
They gonna try to send us to Moval, nigga.
What the hell that say?
Way deep, nigga. The IE went deep.
Damn, for real.
And it's nicknamed the Murder.
What? I know San Bernardino, the Jets.
Yeah.
They fuck around over there.
Oh, yeah.
Mama's.
I'm good in San Bernardino. Oh, we got straps in Bernardino.
Oh, mama's, huh?
We got straps in Bernardino.
I'm going to tap in with Sugar Free in Pomona. Oh, mama's. Let us know. But the Young OG show in North Hollywood, Thursday. You understand me? 9 p.m. We got a lot of special guests. Y'all get y'all tickets right now. Shout out my dog Sling Johnson pulling up to Rob Benz. You know what I'm saying? We every Friday at Rob Benz in Oakland. You understand me? Open mic night. Player shit.
Yeah.
He did his thing. It was good. We enjoyed ourselves. You understand me?
Hell yeah.
Oh, mamas. Let them know. DC?
Yeah, July 8th and 9th. Tap in. DC Comedy Loft. DC. I'm in that bitch. Pull
for
up.
Sure. Oh, my mama.
Oh, and shout out to Tribeca, you feel me? A young nigga out here in a film festival right now, you feel me?
I seen you post that.
You know?
Congratulations,
P. I don't
P.
really be popping a lot of shit, but that's...
You need to be popping.
Tribeca, that's some shit I only heard in the Jay-Z song, nigga. So that shit sound cool on the resume.
Yes, then me.
So yeah, shout out to Real Battle.
How can people watch it though?
I don't know.
Okay.
So it was a short. It got accepted into the thing.
The festival.
Yeah, to the festival. So.
Mm-hmm. And then they go from there.
Yeah, like today, I almost flew out there today, dog. Cause it was the last show and that they was gonna have.
And where's that?
In New York.
You should have done this slid.
I almost thought about it but last
they
minute.
They taxing right now.
Yeah.
Nigga, they charge me so much money. I'm going to Atlanta this month, boy. I'm like, but I've been going to Atlanta for years, bro.
And it ain't never cost this much.
It ain't never cost this much motherfucking money, bro. Yeah. I'm like, whoa.
It's damn near tripling the price of the whole trip.
Bro,
they trying
what?
To get their money back for the pandemic,
they
bro.
Getting their chicken back from the pandemic, bro.
Bro, I was thinking day... I was buying one-ways to places, nigga, day of.
Mm-hmm.
Deciding when I was gonna come back. Now I'm like, fuck that, nigga.
You gotta get an advance,
man.
And they whopping niggas for advance, bro. I'm like, this is unbelievable. I'm like, I've been going to Atlanta for like 7 years straight, every year type shit. Nigga, I ain't never got whopped like this. They getting their chicken back, bro. So I love everybody.
They doing. They raising money to fight the Rico. Fight the YSL Rico, nigga.
That's hella
take
funny.
It out on these flights.
In the rooms. Oh, mamas. Well, shit. It's a Cali Kickback.
God damn it, me.
We chilling. How could you say that shit, man?
God damn it, me.
You understand me? God damn it, me, huh? Yeah. It's the Cali Kickback. My name is Lewis Belt.
Teddy Ray. Theo Brown, whichever way.
I appreciate y'all for fucking with us, man. It's another episode. Tap in. We'll see y'all again.